In this series, I'll help you build the best team comp surrounding your favorite character with just the units you own. That's right, I'll be going through every character in the game. So regardless if you want to build around powerhouse damage dealers like Diluc and Kaching, or if you want to build around less popular DPS units, this is the series for you. After each video, you'll be able to immediately build the team comp that will allow your favorite character to shine, and understand more in depth in the logic and reasoning behind how teams are built. With that said, make sure you're subscribed and have notifications on so that you can follow along. You can also support the series by liking the video and commenting on what character you want to see next. Let's get started. Today, we'll be focusing on the feisty chef, Shang Ling. I love Shang Ling because she's one of those characters that, like Razor, can be built on a budget and still dish out a ton of damage. Additionally, she's one of the best pyro supports in the game and can slot into any team comp. However, today we'll be talking about her primarily as a main DPS. The first thing we want to note is Shang Ling's abilities and elements. Shang Ling is a pyro type and her kit is centered around quick basic attack sequences with Gooba and Pyronado used to proc pyro reactions. At Ascension Rank 4, her Gooba gives her a consistent 10% attack to add onto her base. The unique stat that she gets from Ascension is Elemental Mastery, and while this is not ideal as something like flat attack percentage or crit, it can help raise her reaction damage by a lot as long as we make sure to set it up to where she's the one proccing the reactions. We have to take both her element and her kit into heavy consideration when we build a comp around her, because if she's our main character, we want a team that will set her up for success and amplify her damage as much as possible. So before we even begin picking certain characters to fill into our composition, we need to look at what elemental reactions we want to consistently trigger. I put up a graphic which shows every elemental reaction in the game, and you should spend some time to figure out what each elemental reaction does. With Pyro, we have access to the hardest scaling reactions in the game. Amplifying reactions, which scale the hardest towards late game because it has a multiplier that scales off your attack percentage. And Overload, which is the hardest hitting, transforming reaction in the game. Swirl is also pretty decent with Shang Ling and allows her to deal massive damage against mobs using her Pyronado. Geo is okay, I only have one team that features it. I think if you want to do Geo, Pyro is definitely the element that you want to pair with so you get both Geo Resonance and Pyro Resonance. With this, you're pretty much sacrificing all elemental reaction damage and your EM for raw power. Pyro will boost your flat attack, and then Geo will give you a 15% multiplier, which is pretty strong if you're able to pick up shields consistently. For me personally, if we're looking at elemental reactions in the vacuum, the priority is Cryo, then Hydro, then Animo, then Electro, with Geo just being a very niche case. In addition to elemental reactions, we need to take a quick look at elemental resonance, that is having redundant elements in a single party. For Shang Ling, Fervent Flames is the best because it gives you a 25% attack increase. Since you're running a Pyro DPS, this is very easy to slot in because it only requires one character. Again, Geo Resonance is okay, but you really want to have both Pyro and Geo Resonance together to get the most value out of the multiplier. Let's look at the best teams for Shang Ling DPS. I've gone ahead and labeled comps Abyss Ready if I think that comp is something you can plug and play in Abyss. Again, because the Abyss has different enemies and buffs for each floor, I can't advise you that these comps will work for all 12 floors. That's why I also have listed an Abyss core for each comp that you can build your team around based on the circumstances. Comp 1 features Shang Ling, Cheng Yung, Bennett, and Sucrose. This comp is Abyss ready. This is my best in slot. Shang Ling and Cheng Yung make the perfect 1-2 punch. Cheng Yung putting down the ice field allows you to proc Cryo with your Shang Ling's autos. It also increases your attack speed, which allows you to DPS harder. You will also get the cryo element first, then Gooba or Pyronado will help proc melt. With Gooba, you're looking at about 4 melt procs every cycle, and with its short cooldowns, you're able to spam this combo pretty efficiently. You're picking up Bennett for Pyroresonance and the great healing and steroid that he can provide for your team. The last spot goes to Sucrose, because you do need some help with AoE, and being able to spread cryo and then proc melt with Pyronado is very attractive. Sucrose over Venti, since you can reach your enemies better, but again any animo like Venti or Jean can work here. The Abyss core for this comp is Shang Ling, Chang Yung, Flex for healer, and Flex for an animo. The combo for this comp against mobs is Chang Yung Yi into Sucrose Q, Shang Ling Q, Shang Ling auto attack until Sucrose Q wears off, then Sucrose E, Chang Yung Q, and then Shang Ling E for the last melt proc. The combo for single target goes Chang Yung E into Shang Ling E, and then Shang Ling auto attack, and there you can get a lot of melt procs off. Comp 2 features Shang Ling, Diona or Chi Chi with Kaio being an okay replacement, Fischl and Sucrose, or Venti and Jean. This comp is Abyss ready. Without Chang Yung, your next go-to option is Diona. She's still able to provide melt reactions. Here, you're using her E just for the cryo proc alone, so you'll be pressing it instead of holding it for the shorter cooldown. You can combo off her ult with Shang Ling's ult, and along with Sucrose, deal massive AoE melt damage to shred through mobs easily. Chang Yung definitely gets you more melt procs on average, but Diona is great if you don't have access to him. Chi Chi is also really great. I have Diona listed first for a more budget option, but with the right resources, Chi Chi and Diona are interchangeable. Instead of a Bennett, which provides redundant healing, I've chosen to not take the pyro buff in exchange for more versatility. Especially without Chang Yung turning your basic attacks into cryo, triggering super conduct with Diona and Fischl will help Shang Ling deal with beefy single targets. The Abyss core for this comp is Shang Ling, Diona, Flex, and then you Flex for an animo. The combo against mobs for this comp is Sucrose Q into Diona Q, Shang Ling Q, Shang Ling auto attack until Sucrose Q wears off, Diona E, Sucrose E, Shang Ling E, and then you finish up with Fischl E to proc more overload once that melt proc fades. The combo sequence for single target is Diona E into Fischl E for superconduct, Shang Ling E for overload after superconduct, and then Shang Ling auto attack for 8 to 9 seconds, and then you basically rinse and repeat this cycle. Comp 3 features Shang Ling, Xingqiu or Mona, Bennett, and Sucrose or Venti and Jean. This comp is Abyss ready. This comp plays for Vaporize instead of Melt. I think these comps are generally weaker than the Melt comps, just because Shang Ling gets so much passive EM, so being able to proc the reaction with Pyro is ideal to get the greatest damage multiplier. Xingqiu works pretty well with Shang Ling. She has really fast attack speed, so you'll be able to get a lot of value out of his water swords. It has decent synergy with Gooba, but since Shang Ling attacks so fast, the majority of the time you'll be proccing Vaporize with Pyro instead of Hydro, so you're only getting a 1.5 times damage amplifier. Mona is okay too, but I feel Shang Ling doesn't take advantage of her kit as much as someone who has stronger and more consistent AoE damage. Bennett is here for the Pyro Resonance and healing just in case. No real combo sequence here, just try to proc Vaporize with Xingqiu E after applying Pyro with Shang Ling. Xingqiu Burst along with Shang Ling Burst and E allows you to get a lot of damage from the Water Swords. Sacrificial Sword is a great option for Xingqiu and helps proc reactions more consistently since his E cooldown is so long. The Abyss core for this comp is Shang Ling, Xingqiu, Flex for healer, and Flex for an animo. Comp 4 features Shang Ling, Bennett, Traveler, and Noelle, but Zhongli on release. This comp is Abyss ready. You're picking up both Pyro and Geo Resonance for this comp and focusing on raw power instead of strong elemental reactions. bullet 4-piece set for Shangling is a very strong consideration, as you'll almost always have a shield up with Noel or Zhongli when he comes out. Noel as a Claymore user helps to deal with any tough shields you may encounter, and if the leaks are true, Zhongli's Q would be able to turn all shields into Geo, which makes it a lot easier for you to deal with those pesky Abyss Mages. Zhongli in place of Noel is a huge buff in terms of added AoE damage, with both MC and Zhongli serving the role of burst support. No real combo sequence here, but for Noel's and Zhongli's shield, to make sure to pick up shield fragments to achieve your 15% multiplier from Geo along with the bullet 4-piece buff. I'd much prefer running Gladiator if you don't have Zhongli. With all the resistances from shields, Bennett's field becomes more of a buff than healing, but a great safety net if you fall low. The Abyss core for this comp is Shangling, Traveler, Zhongli, or Noel until Zhongli comes out, and then flex for a healer. Comp 5 is my free-to-play and features Shangling, Kaya, Fischl, and Barbara with Thrilling Tales. This is my favorite iteration of a free-to-play team. Very similar to comp 2, this comp provides versatility in proccing either Melt with Kaya and Shangling burst synergy, or playing for super conduct with Fischl and Kaya to grant your Shangling a huge boost in basic attacks. You have so many choices for how to play this comp, and Barbara rounds it all up with great healing and Thrilling Tales buff. This comp will destroy an Abyss because of the tools that it has at its disposal. I've listed all characters I didn't mention with their reasoning. If you want to find out why I didn't include a certain character in the team comp, make sure to pause the video and give it a read. Thank you for checking out episode 7 of my team build series. I'd really like to hear from you guys as to what your favorite team is so far. Comment down below with your current party setup. I'd love to check all of them out. If you enjoyed this video, please consider leaving a like and subscribing to my channel. Your support goes a long way in helping me put out quality Genshin Impact content every week. Also, check out some of my other Genshin Impact content if you haven't already. Thanks for watching. Till next time.